How much of that did you... Never mind. Welcome to the Homeschool Hub. My name is Phil, and you are in my space, my musical space, because I was having a bit of a dance, and that is perfectly all right. In fact, I encourage it. I am welcoming you to this space, because today, not only was I listening to some music, but we're going to be talking about sound today. And everything that I do today will be sound, because you will be able to have a go of it yourself. You'll be able to engineer your own little sound mixing station. We're going to talk about speakers and actually how they work. And we're going to do a little bit of an experiment. So not only can you hear sound, but potentially that you might be able to see it, which stuff that you can try yourself. So what you will need for this is a bowl, and this can be any kind of a bowl or opening that there is kind of, even a box will work. We're gonna put some cling film over it, and we're gonna drape this over our bowl here, and we're gonna create like a drum. And drums are often the kind of things you'd imagine you'd hear sound, like when you hit them, you create noise. And what you're actually creating when you hit a drum is you're creating vibrations. And sound is a vibration. There are different types of waves in science. There are, hello waves. There are transverse waves that you'll see that go up and down like the ocean, but then there are something else called longitudinal waves. And those are waves, sound waves that kind of compress and move around, and they transform and travel in vibrations. And sound travels differently depending on what material it's traveling through. If it's going through air, I'll sound like this. If I was traveling through water, it'll travel much quicker. And that means it will sound a little bit different. Okay, so I have put sandwich cling film that we have repurposed here, and you'll hear now that because of that taut nature, means it's been stretched, you can hear it kind of vibrating. Now, but that is not the experiment. I wouldn't leave you with just with that. As much fun as this would be to bang away, we're gonna make much more annoying noise shortly. So what we've done is we have this ready to go. We're now gonna get my favorite ingredient to use, which is, and I have not hundreds, but thousands, hundreds and thousands, because it's hundreds and thousands. I'm going to open this, and I'm not gonna eat them yet, but I'm gonna put some on top of this. You'll hear the noise. Whoop. Oh, they look so colorful. You can hear them there. Oh, they're spilling all over. I will clean this up. Don't worry. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get down nice and low, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to hum. So humming vibrations here are gonna transfer into sound. Sound will travel through a vibration in the air, cause these to then vibrate and dance, hopefully. Ready? So I'm gonna start over here and then come close. You ready? I think that worked. I didn't expect that to work so well. That's awesome. So let's see if we can try it with something bigger and see if it'll work that way. So I brought in some breakfast with me, some little brown blisters of air, little cocoa rice things. So if I put them there. Now, will these, now the vibration needs to be big enough to make these go, but let's see if I can do it. So I'll go. It's almost like I'm using the power of my mind. Now, why is this useful and how does it apply to speakers? Well, this is essentially how speakers work. They use vibrations to be able to let you hear wonderful noise. And if you look at your speakers, like I said, in a sound system, there's always this kind of like, there's a dish, like a round shape, but there's a middle bit. And it's that middle bit that vibrates back and forth. There's a magnet in that, and it vibrates back and forth when electrical signals are put in it. And because it hits, it's connected to that big dish that moves back and forward, and it creates these wave patterns, these sound wave patterns that then travel out. And because you've got something bigger and wider, it's able to sound louder and louder. So bigger speakers need bigger dishes, or if it needs a more efficient way of transferring those vibrations to cause those discs to vibrate. Now, I happen to have a snazzy little thing here, which is, it's a little speaker system, but what it is, it's not just a speaker, it's like the middle bit of a speaker, and it connects to random things to be able to create sound. So what you do is you take this little sticky bit off, and when you press it, it acts as that middle bit of a speaker, creates vibrations, and if you put it and connect it to like a flat surface, it should be able to make the noise of a speaker, it should sound louder. So I have my phone here, and I have a song lined up. So if I start playing the song, That's how it sounds on my phone. But then when if I connect it up into this little speaker, the middle bit, it should sound a little bit quiet. But then when I connect it to a flat surface, it should sound louder because it's acting as it. So if I have it like this, kind of quiet, but flat surface, sounds a bit louder. But this is a little bit, won't vibrate that much. Piece of Perspex, or Perspex even. So large piece of Perspex, should be able to vibrate a good bit. See how it, like, it gets louder when I put it in? So quiet. Easier to hear because the vibrations are being amplified. They're bigger. So this is like the central part of a speaker. So if I put that there, good song. So other things that shake or vibrate, like if you get a box that you can get these signals inside to bounce around and cause it. So this will move. See that? This is moved like a drum moves. So if I put it in here. Not bad, huh? Okay, we'll take it off. Quiet, 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 quiet. Perfect. Or like, would it work on these? That's a good idea. Actually, hold on. No. Quiet. There, put that there. Okay, sprinkles. It's gonna be like my, will this work? Okay, this is awesome. I have like a sprinkle party, and if I could have the sound up much enough, it would like spray into my mouth, and I would eat, and I would be happy, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do. What I would like you to do is to send in your ideas on how you could use this ordinary.ia/learn, or a post box, or whatever. But into some music, have some fun. And music and speak. Look at the speakers, look at the little bit. These are delicious. We'll see you next time, bye.
Behi Vakarda, I hope you're full of beans today for Exercise with Emer, because today we are doing a crazy Minions dance and I'm really excited. So I'll teach you the moves first and then we'll try it to the music. Now remember, dance like nobody is watching you, be free and just have some fun. There are no wrong moves as long as you're moving. Okay, so the first move is arms folded. Then we go punch out, punch down, back to folded again. Then punch out, punch down, back to fold it again. We do that 4 times. Then the music goes banana. And when that happens, we're gonna do reach the sky, reach to the sky, reach to the sky. Then the song speeds up. So we're gonna start quick feet, crazy hands, and we're gonna do big circle. And then we're into a one hop and a fist pump, okay? So it's like this. And then we come to the center and we're gonna go out and in and go to the other side, fist pump, come back to center, out and in, okay? Then we just go walk, walk, walk with attitude, walk, 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 attitude, walk, walk, walk. Then we're gonna go up like this, round in a circle, round in a circle, round in a circle. Then we're back into basically the chorus. So it, instead of this time where, or the last time, sorry, we went here to here to here, we're actually gonna do a couple of these. So it's gonna go out, down, then to here. Out, down, then to here. And then everything else is the same. We just keep repeating the moves that we've already done. And then there's a little section in there towards the end where I want you to just have fun. You can do whatever dance move you want. And then we'll finish with a dab. Sound good? Okay, so we're gonna start from the beginning of the dance and we're gonna do it to music this time. So this is our first pose. So let's get ready, feeling confident. Let's have some fun. Here we go. Arms out and down, back to center, again. Back to center. Good job. All right, we're going reach now. Great, yes. Woo! Crazy, crazy, crazy! We're hopping on one leg. Let's go. Out, in. All right. Great. Out, in. Good job. Here we can get a little bit of a break. Okay, circle waist, and it's gonna go nice and slow. Yeah. Get down into that squat, good job. Here we go. Nice work, nice work. Hey, back into action. So we're doing twice, remember, punch, 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 punch. Last one. Reaching for the sky. Oh yeah, woo! Okay, crazy, crazy dancing. Spin. And hop, ready? Tu le veras con la papaya. Super job. Attitude, give me some attitude. Okay, we're gonna bounce. Woo. All right, I think it's time for some freestyle. What are you gonna do? All right, what are you doing at home? That was amazing, guys. I'm gonna end with a dab. Well done, and I hope you had loads of fun. I'm sweaty, oh, my heart rate is up, I'm full of energy right now. How do you feel? It's so funny because you think dancing, it's just a bit of fun, but you actually get a great workout as well, because it's basically like aerobics. I just want to say, you were brilliant today, and I really hope that you had lots of fun. I will see you soon. Swan! So